also called trans campaigners authoritarian, haven't you? I mean, isn't that grossly...
Well, only in the broader context of my claims that radical leftist ideologues are authoritarian,
yes,
which they are.
You're saying someone who is trying to work out their gender identity, who may well have struggled with that, had quite a
no
tough
doubt
time over
struggled
the years.
With it, yeah.
You're comparing them with, you know, Chairman Mao, who
no, just
saw the,
the
deaths of millions of people. Well,
just
even
activists.
If the activists, you know, they're trans people too.
Not necessarily. At least not the people pushing this stuff. I mean, you don't get a bill passed in Parliament and authorized by the Senate solely on the votes of trans people, Kathy. Which only goes to Peterson's point. This isn't about trans people. It's about authoritarianism. It's about an ideology. It's about compelled speech based on theories cooked up in humanities departments that not only have no scientific backing, but that are contraindicated by what science we do have available, including the science around transgenderism. And it's about the larger ideology that has incorporated trans activism under its rubric. It literally reached out a pseudopod, absorbed all of those trans people, and said, now this thing, this mass of theories and bullshit, now it speaks for you. Was Bill C-16 the hill Peterson should have planted his flag on? Maybe not. But he had to pick a hill, didn't he? And now that his flag has attracted so much attention, he's barely talking about trans issues, let alone pronouns. You know, it's only the progressive press who keep bringing it up, because trans people in their exquisite social vulnerability make beautiful human shields. Oh, you want to fight us? You want to fight us, Dr. Peterson? Well, you're just going to have to mow down all of these trans people first. That's what you're doing. You're using a vulnerable population as a human shield to protect your ideology.